Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Chicago Cubs franchise series here in MLB 14, the show on the PS4. The Cubs have just finished a home and away series with their hometown rival, the Chicago White Sox, and now it is time to fast forward the schedule a little bit here. We're going to try to get this going. By the end of this, we will move somewhere into June in this episode, and we'll go from there. So we see a little issue there with John Baker getting hurt, and Javier Baez, there we go, one of our big prospects, he and Chris Bryant, and now Baez is finally not injured, meaning we can move him up to the big club if we like. And yeah, of course we want to move him up here and get major league experience, so we're gonna do just that in just a second. Gonna go down and get Baez on the 40-man roster and then get him up on the major league roster. So we're going to go ahead and do that. He's promoted to the big club where Chris Bryant already is. And we've got our two best prospects now up with the big club and going to try to prove themselves. So we left the last episode talking about Jeff Samardzija and talking about Hamill and should we deal them like they did in real life. Lot of answers back and forth, but for now they stay put. And Jeff Samardzija will actually get the start against the Cardinals today at Busch Stadium, hoping to avoid a four-game sweep. Yes, the Cardinals have won the first three of this series, so we're stepping in for a couple reasons. Got to stop that losing streak and beat the rival Cardinals. And we've got a chance to debut Javier Baez with the Cubs, and we did not want to miss that. So he's going to jump right in the lineup there in the second spot, and he's going to join fellow prospect Chris Bryant in that lineup. So let's see what they can do today and hopefully avoid a four-game sweep. We definitely do not want that going against us. So here we go in the first inning. That's going to be Starlin Castro, and he is going to ground out. Nothing doing for the Cubs in the first. So we will move on to the bottom of the inning, and Jeff Samardzija on the mound facing Carpenter, and he takes that down the first baseline. It's knocked down by Rizzo. He gets up and locates it and tosses it just in time to Samardzija covering the bag. Nice play right there to rob Carpenter of a hit. So it is a 3-2 count with two outs to Alan Craig, and he is going to fly out to left field. So Samardzija gets out of the first inning. We go on to the top of the second and see if the Cubs can do anything offensively right there. So you see Scherholz at the plate, 2-1 count, and he's going to hit this high towering shot to left center field. It is going to get off the fence, and one hop going to be thrown in. He's going to try to go for three. The relay not even going to get a throw to third base. Nate Scherholz hits a triple in the second inning. Now the Cubs need to pick him up and get him home. First, let's watch the replay here. And he hits this ball very high and very deep to left center field. Stays in the ballpark, but he gets to third base. So here we go with Ruggiano at the plate and one out. And he's going to hit him home. Gets that past third base and out to left field. It's a base hit, an RBI for Justin Ruggiano. Nice at bat right there. And the Cubs take the 1-0 lead. Might get a replay right here. Yes, indeed. This is pulled down to third base and cannot quite make the play on the backhanded attempt. Base hit to left field, and Scherholz comes around to score. On to the bottom of the second now. Two runners on. Samardzija with a little bit of trouble, but he gets a strikeout on the splitter, and that will end the inning. So he's able to escape the problem he makes for himself. Here is Chris Bryant in the third, 1-0 game, and he's going to get a base hit to left center right there. It drops, and he is on. So we'll see if this leads to anything. Here is Javier Baez, already had his first play appearance, looking for his first major league hit, and that's a nice play to start maybe a double play. No, Baez is too fast, so it's not a hit, but he's not retired on the play either. He will be on base as he gets down that line quickly. So there you go, kind of a glimpse at the future of the Cubs. Baez at first, Bryant at third, but Castro strikes out, and that will be the end of that. Starlin Castro not so happy with himself with that at bat. It remains 1-0, as the top of the third is over, we go to the bottom of the inning, and Carpenter's up again, 1-2 count, and he's striking out on the slider in. That doesn't look like he put a real good at-bat together there, as Samardzija makes him look kind of funny. Let's watch it once again. Yeah, got him tied up, and kind of a feeble swing at the pitch. Samardzija wins that round. Now with two outs and two strikes, he gets strike three right there as well. I think he actually struck out the side in that inning, just getting stronger as we are through three innings. Just one hit for the Cardinals at this point, and they've got nothing across on the board. Let's see if we can get a little bit added to our cushion here as Wellington Castillo is at the plate. He's going to knock that to right for a base hit and drive home the second run of the game. It is now 2-0 Cubs as they're able to get a run home from third base. Bottom of the fourth now, 3-2, two outs, and that is strike three swinging, 94 mile an hour. Cannot catch up to it. The Cubs stay right in that 2-0 lead. Still, Samardzija only has given up one hit. Fifth inning now, and Castro is going to ground out. Yeah, not much going on there. So it'll remain a 2-0 Cubs score. Let's see if the Cardinals can get anything going in the bottom of the fifth. 3-1 count, one out. This is a dribbler to the mound, and that is trying to get the out at third, but the throw takes Chris Bryant off the bag. Samardzija had his momentum going that way, but he messes it up. That's an error on him, and now with one out, he's got the bases loaded, but he gets Carpenter again. Oh, wow, Carpenter just having all sorts of troubles with Samardzija. Can he get out of this bases loaded jam? He does with back-to-back strikeouts. Wow, he really bore down there and got the job done. And when it looked like the Cardinals were going to break through, maybe even tie this game or take the lead, instead, they strand the bases loaded. So here's Nate Scherholz, who has tripled already, and he pulls this one into the gap in right center, and it's going to roll a while. He is going to go for second. Is he thinking three once again? Yes, he is. Here comes the relay throw, and he's got his second triple of the game. Nate Scherholz, who is not exactly a speedster, hits two triples in the same game. Let's watch this one. Oh, yeah. So it gets over the second baseman's head, and then it is going to roll forever into the gap. He stands up at third base. Scherholz once again in scoring position, but there are now two outs. And Castillo again at the plate. Base hit. The second baseman can't come up with it. An RBI single, and the Cubs lead 3-0. So far, so good on the road, trying to salvage one win out of the series. But we still want to see something special out of Javier Baez's debut. We haven't seen him get a hit yet. There's still time. Maybe he will get something done. But first, we see Chris Bryant coming up 1-for-2. He had that single, but he is looking for more. So with two outs and a 2-1 count, he rips this high, deep to right center field. It's going to get out of the ballpark in its very first home run in the major leagues. Chris Bryant hits the first of what hopefully is many. Randy Choate doesn't like it because he just surrendered a two-run homer to the rookie. But Chris Bryant, congratulations. That is the first major league home run. All right, that feels good. We're going to see a nice replay of this. Took it opposite field into the gap, and it clears the fence. 416 feet. Nice shot by Chris Bryant. He makes it a 5-0 Cubs lead. And when this comes down, hopefully he can get that baseball back. Maybe somebody will retrieve that for him and be nice enough to give him back that milestone baseball. Here he gets the silent treatment and finally gets mobbed by his teammates in the dugout. Great moment right there for Chris Bryant. Young guy in his rookie at-bats here, and he finally takes one deep. So Samardzija comes through with another strikeout, and he is strong through six innings, still just two hits. We move forward to the top of the seventh now, and Javier Baez 0-for-3, hoping still that today he'll get that first major league hit. One out, a 2-2 count, and Pat Neshek in the game. He's gonna get it to center field. So Chris Bryant hits his first home run, and Javier Baez gets his first major league hit. It's a day of milestones for our future stars. And there it is. Baez can celebrate the first major league hit. Throw that ball out of play. He'll want to keep that one. And that's exactly what the Cubs are going to do right there. Put that one under safekeeping for the rookie. Okay, so he gives it to Chris Bryant, who obviously understands the meaning of a first hit. So he's going to guard that for his fellow rookie. And we see a replay. He's taking Pat Neshek, the submariner, right back to center field and getting the hit. So now all there is to do is finish this out, a win for the Cubs, and save face of being swept at Busch Stadium. Scherholz is going to get another hit. This makes him 4-for-4 at this point, and it's going to be an RBI as well. Tack on a sixth run, and that's Baez, who comes home to score, showing some speed. Nate Scherholz, 4-for-4 on the day, having a great game, and Baez is all fired up for scoring that run. So we go bottom of the seventh, and a bit of trouble. Rizzo cannot backhand that, and it gets away out in right field. Not played very well. Two runs will score. Might have scored two anyway. On the double. So here come the Cardinals. Hold on. It's 6-2. Pedro Strop will be coming in out of the bullpen to relieve a very good start put in by Jeff Samardzija. But he kind of ran out of gas. So with runners at the corners. Oh, speaking of gas, Pedro Strop comes in and strikes out the batter to end the inning. It is 6-2. It'll stay right there. So we're going to move on to the eighth inning. Chris Bryant has homered. He goes opposite field deep again, and it's off the wall. He just missed his second home run of the game, but he will have a double hustling into second. Chris Bryant gets it done, and he's a little dirty there, but he is definitely saying it's worth the effort, sliding headfirst into second base. Oh, so close to having a two-homer ball game, his first ever and almost his second ever home run in the same game, but he will get the double. So we go to the ninth, and James Russell is in. We don't have a save opportunity, but he is doing a nice job getting things done, and that will finish off the ball game. So the Cubs take one out of the four here in St. Louis, and, well, at least they get a victory and don't get swept out of town. So it's something to build on. It was a glimpse of the future. As you see, Baez and Castro are going to make a very nice middle infield for some time to come. You got Chris Bryant over at third base. Things should be looking up for the Cubs, at least as potential-wise, as it's starting to show up on the field here. Hopefully they can get some experience and we can build towards a next season here. Nate Scherholz goes 4-for-5, including two triples, and is your player of the game. He does a real nice job pitching in today, as we did a much better job with runners in scoring position, getting some of those guys home. That's something we don't always do. So we're 18-23. Like I said, we're going to fast forward a little bit. I'm going to wave the magic wand, and all of a sudden, it's June. There we go. We're now 37-38. Actually doing all right. Just one game under 500. Pretty good for where we were. So we're going to be almost through June here. We're going to speed things up a little bit better pace here. Maybe hit a month at a time for a while, and continue this Cubs franchise towards the future, hopefully more promising than the present. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.